Sup guys, Merkeebs here, and in this video, I'll be taking a look at the Boog 75, a gaming-focused version of Mellatrix's Zoom 75. But before anything else, you should know that Mellatrix did send me this board for me to check out and give my honest thoughts on. But like all my other reviews, all thoughts and opinions are always my own. So with that being said, on to the rest of the video. Okay, so by now, a lot of people in the mechanical keyboard community are probably already familiar with Mellatrix from their Zoom series of keyboards. Like their Zoom 65, Zoom TKL, Zoom 98, 75, and so on. But now the team at Mellatrix have taken a pretty unique spin to their existing board, the Zoom 75, and given it some new hardware in the form of this Boog 75. So the Boog 75 is available from Mellatrix's site as well as participating regional vendors as a pre-built board for $229.99. and is available in two themed colorways. Shockwave, which comes in a black and teal cyberpunkish theme, and the other available colorway is called Induction Coil, which is available in this cleaner looking white and gold theme. But let's say you're already someone that owns one of Mellatrix's Zoom 75s. Well, in that case, Mellatrix have made the Boog 75's HE module available for purchase separately for $99.99. The module includes an aluminum plate, plate foam, the Hall Effect PCB, and a set of Gateron KS37B switches, all put together as an entire assembly. Now for the unboxing, there really isn't much included. The board came in this nice black Mellatrix branded carrying case, and then all that was inside was the board itself wrapped in plastic, a braided coiled USB Type-C to Type-A cable, and a set of hex keys to open up the board with. Now let's take a look at the board. If you're familiar with Mellatrix's Zoom 75, this should all look very familiar to you. It's a standard ANSI layout, non-exploded 75% keyboard with some per-key customizable RGB lighting. The case design is pretty much unchanged, with the main changes being the aesthetics of this induction coil-themed colorway. All around the board, there are these curvy gold lines pretty much covering a significant portion of the case's surface area, but it's done in a way that doesn't look overdone or gaudy. Honestly, for me, the design looks pretty tasteful and minimal. That is until you take a look at the bottom of the case and see this massive golden bottom with this external weight that has the same curved line patterns pretty much covering the entire surface area. Other than that, you get four rubber case feet, and then on the rear of the board you'll find the USB-C port right in the middle. Now, unlike the Zoom 75, for the layout you're strictly limited to just having the 2-key module on the top right side of the board, since the PCB is just one whole piece now and doesn't support installation of any of the Zoom 75's modules. So don't expect to be able to install any of Mellatrix's Zoom 75's other modules, like the screen, knob, or badge. Now when it comes to software customizability, for messing with the board's functions and features, Mellatrix have developed this really helpful web driver that lets you mess with the board. Now since the board is a lot more heavily focused on gaming performance, aside from the usual ability to change lighting settings, set up macros, and change up key mappings, Mellatrix's software allows you to change the actuation point on any of the keys from as low as 0.1mm all the way to full travel at 4mm. So you're free to set the actuation point of any of the switches to anywhere you see fit. Then one feature that's more useful for those of you playing first-person shooters is Rapid Trigger, which lets you instantly activate the key when you want to press and deactivates it upon release. In a nutshell, it makes physical keystroke latency basically non-existent. Now I'll be taking the board apart to show you what the board has going for it under the hood. Starting with the keycaps are a nice and high quality double shot PBT set in a white and gold theme to match the overall look of the board, with some nice and simple legends. The texture is overall pretty smooth with just a little bit of micro texture for a bit of grip. Then taking a look at the switches, since this is a Hall Effect keyboard, the board is using these Gateron KS37B Hall Effect switches. The switches are factory lubed and are plenty smooth, making them good to use out of the box without any relubing needed. The same can be said about the included stabilizers. The screw-in stabs that came with my board are lubed and tuned insanely well, to a point where I don't personally feel the need to take them apart to relube or retune them any further, which is definitely a welcome inclusion, and a nice touch for Mellatrix because with the target market of this board being gamers, not everyone is gonna have the time nor the patience to work on their stabs. And now I'll be opening up the board. Now, there's honestly really no need to open up the board for the regular user, but for video purposes, to get it open, you'll need to remove four hex screws keeping the top and bottom case pieces together. Once the hex screws are off, we can take a look at the internals. Starting with the bottom case, the case comes with some included case foam to fill up the hollowed out parts inside the underside of the casing, since the Boog 75 is after all reusing the same chassis as the Zoom 75, which has cutouts for two batteries and an internal case weight. Then checking out the plate assembly, it's gasket mounted using these gaskets that slide onto tabs surrounding the aluminum plate. This effectively isolates the assembly from making direct contact with the case, making for a pretty nice sounding board overall. In between the PCB and plate, we'll also find some plate foam, and behind the PCB we'll find some rear PCB foam for additional sound dampening. The PCB itself is the main star of the show, and it's basically what makes this a Hall Effect keyboard in the first place. Because rather than using mechanical hot swap sockets, the PCB is designed to take magnetic signals from MX-style magnetic switches, just like the included Gateron KS37Bs, and uses the magnets from those switches to register your keystrokes. And that's pretty much it for the overview of the board. Now here's a quick sound test of the board completely stock, then I'll be giving my overall thoughts right after. So starting with sound, as far as Hall Effect keyboards are concerned, this is on the top of my list as the best sounding Hall Effect keyboard I've gotten the pleasure of trying out. Normally Hall Effect keyboards aren't really known for their amazing acoustic performance, but given how much work Mellotrix has really put into foaming up the board, there's no hollowness, no ping, and no undesirable sounds. Just a nice muted thock that sounds deep and creamy. Not something I ever thought I'd say about a Hall Effect keyboard if I'm being honest. Now talking about feel, the board itself does feel pretty stiff, but definitely not tray mount levels of stiff. But don't get me wrong, that's entirely by design, because if the board ever flexed or bounced like every other mechanical keyboard on the market, it could really mess with how the PCB receives signals from the magnets, since everything is calculated on a per millimeter basis. Now talking about performance, it's just phenomenal. The ability to customize the board functions with rapid trigger, the ability to set your desired actuation point on a per key basis, and just the sheer level of functional customizability on offer makes this keyboard a great fit for just about everyone, especially if you're someone that wants to really dial in how you want to perform with your board. Mellotrix have really released a banger here. And while the $229 retail price can seem steep, I can safely say it's worth the price tag, especially when you put it up against so-called gaming keyboards from other competing brands. Honestly, a lot of other gaming keyboards just pale in comparison. This is probably one of, if not the best gaming keyboard on the market in 2024. And it's only gonna get better from here. Cause as of recording this video, Mellotrix has announced that their Zoom 65 V3, which is basically a 65% version of this board, just with a different mounting system and a few quality of life improvements, is gonna get the Hall Effect treatment as well in the form of an HE switch module. So if you're not big on 75% and want something a little bit smaller doing away with the function row, then that's another top performer for you to wait on. And with that being said, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment and drop a like, as these videos take a lot of work. And if you want to see more content just like this, please consider subscribing. It really means a lot. Thanks to Mellotrix for sending this board out for review, and all relevant links will be in the video description down below. Thank you guys for watching. Till next time. Merkeebs out.